Today is the sixth day of the second month on our Maker's Restored calendar. Makes it 206. Day number 206 of the year is 726, and it's the day that I got the golden belt for the belt of Uphaz, the belt of Ophir, if you will, or the belt of Uphaz of Daniel chapter 10. The golden belt back then several years ago. The gold came in, and the belt was made on 728, and it was put on 729. But the gold came in the mail that day. So quite remarkable. Today's the 1335th day from the Elijah dream, the phone call from Elijah dream with the steamboat mattress and crushing that 325 gallon, I will be silent and pour, a Hazareth water tank. But all quite remarkable. It's because Daniel chapter 12 talks about blessed is he or happy is he that waits and touches the 1335th day. And I really do believe today is that day for lots of reasons. And I should have probably brought notes because I have so many important details I want to cover. And I probably forget some of them, and that's just what it is. But the sun's coming out from the cloud now, because the Son of Righteousness is getting ready to be risen up before your faces indeed. But anyway, today is the sixth day of the March. 206 is the sixth day of the March around the stench of a month. And your stench, a.k.a. Jericho, your stenches of a month, and your profaning of our Maker's appointed times and his Sabbaths and such. And that's just reality, how he paralleled it in these 6 days with the 6 days of his creation. And the sixth day he said, I will make man in my image. So Elohim made man to be in the image of Elohim. And the image of him ties into Hosea 2:16 for light. Hosea 2:16 says that you're not going to call me Baali anymore. You're going to call me Ishai, which is Strong's number 376 for man. My initials even spell man, but it's in here in Elohim's stead. So it's just in how that ties into Isaiah chapter 63. I'll get to in a little bit here as we move forward. But remarkable, because tonight's 90 zillion Powerball ties into his 3 30-day periods on each side of the scattering of my hair that he used to restore his appointed times that you're profaning by not turning back to him and such, and plus your own profanings of your servant Satan's calendar and everything else. But it's just all beyond remarkable how it's all tying together. But for instance, today's the 841st night of the Abraham lamp at the Mount of Olives. And the 841st day of me approaching near to him 3 strokes a day was the day I was arrested on 229. And that even ties into now. But in Genesis 49, he says that I'm going to wash my clothes in wine, my persuasion in the blood of the grapes. And that is Genesis 49:11, and that event happened on 807 of our Maker's restored calendar of the year 6001. And he opened the three tiers of boat in the year 601, servant Noah. But he showed me that day that his servant Noah was born into the world on that day. Day number 217 of the year, according to his restored calendar, the day he sent the flood. So he showed me that back then, and I'm pretty sure I spoke about the video, but maybe I didn't. I marked it on the calendar, and he uncovered it, and the day he was born, as it was in days of Noah, into the world. And then today is 539 days later from when I washed my 2 bottles of wine that day. I used to wash my clothes in wine, my persuasion in the blood of the grapes. But 2 bottles of wine, and I literally washed them in that day. But 539 days later is today, and Psalm 539 is to believe Yehweh. And the first time it's used is in Genesis 15, that blessing prophecy for me, the Ching prophecy, that he's going to be my exceedingly great abundant reward. And that's just what it is, in association with 400 days, a day for a year. How that ties into this is remarkable as well. But it means tomorrow would be day number 540 from that washing my blood and grapes. If he does this tonight, I would be traveling out of here tomorrow with my clothes fermented red, which I'll get to in a bit with Isaiah 63. But 539 days later to believe him. So you're going to get to see quite the extravaganza today because I believe him. And you're going to see a third bottle of washing that's here in my hand. But truly, truly, truly remarkable. So 540 means it's using Daniel, but you can know for sure, certainty that this is going to happen. And I believe for certainly it's going to happen with these next three draws. Because today is bottle number 245 of the Living Waters. And 245 is 9-5. And he brought us to his holy mountain, to Zion, on 9-5. It was 11-13 of 2014 on his servant Satan's calendar. But 9-5. And the day that I did the first video on 12-12-2010 on Satan's calendar, turning the waters into blood. But I'm just getting heavy with one hand, so I'm going to hold it with both hands. But anyway, we'll turn the waters into blood that day, symbolic of those six purification stone pots for the Jews used for ritual purification. How Yeshua with the wedding of Canaan that day, had his father turned those six pots of 20 to 30 firkins filled with to the rim with waters to turn into the wine, and it was a good wine too, the best wine. And oddly enough, 245 tonight's Living Waters, but there's one more bottle in the box, and it's this bottle. Tomorrow night's 246 bottle of Living Waters. And it's the last bottle of the 31st box, parallel to 31 Kings, and a whole bunch of stuff as well that Yeshua and company smoked on the west of the Jordan and such, and I'll be traveling west of the Jordan to cash these tickets. But the 246, drunk's number 246, this is bottle 246, it's tomorrow night's wine. As you see, the seal's already been broken, and the cork is ready to pop. But for tomorrow night's 246, it's only used one place. It's referred to Jeremiah's chains. Well, Jeremiah got the chains removed. Jeremiah's chains removed after they lifted him up from the by the armhole pivots. It's just used three places as well. And before I get into that, 9-5 when he brought us to Zion plus 2671 is today for sword, or maybe it's 27. Anyway, it's a sword. I might be wrong on the number, but it's a sword. And Z stands for the sword. And see, we're in the news now with the people supporting Russia's at war with their Z's on their tanks and stuff. They're wearing Z's on their clothing and such. And little they know that it's how it ties into World War Z. But and Zerubbabel standing before your face. Well, this is a bottle of Zinfandel Z wine, 14.8%. Day number 148 is 528, the day of the Elijah trek with his Ezekiel chapter 10 rolling thing. So, but it's a really good wine. But it's got a plant on the front. It says what it is, but it's not a hyssop. But boy, it sure resembles the hyssop plant in a great way. But regardless, do all this talk about the hyssop plant is recently. But Jeremiah's chain, only the place that 679, they lifted him up from the armpits, and it's used for the armpit or armhole cubit of the 11-foot reed with those they call the great cubit in his end time son of Adam prophecy. The 1260th day was 1121 for sun from the Elijah dream, and now we had, and I changed my clothing at that point because the clothes that were washed in wine, I changed them as a result of that 1260th day. But I couldn't put them on anymore. They were so ripped up. So I changed them and put on these clothes. So in Isaiah 63, he says, "Who is this that comes from Edom with his clothes fermented?" And it says died from. Edom refers to those of you at the land of those of you who sold your birthrights for the things of this world for a bowl of pottage, red pottage. But you sow, and in the next verse, in verse 2, it says that I'm going to have my who is this, all glorious is apparel, red, which is drunk number 122, Edom's 123. But red is what Edom means. But it's referred to those, again, that sold you birthrights, those of you that sold your birthrights for that which is of the world. But Bozrah is the sheep enclosure, and he gives me the key of David, the key to the gate, the sheep gate. And it's just what it is. I am the pathway and light, and there's no other way but the pathway of me, the word of Elohim. And I'm the gate, but there's this sheep enclosure, it's Basra. But it's a close fermented. And when he brought us to the Mount of Olives, it was where he had hid the three measures of leavening for 217 days. I thought that was the three measures of leavening, but then you tie it into to, because there were literally three measures of leavening there for 217 days for day number 217, Noah's birthday. And he sent the flood again on 217, which is day 47 of the year. But I washed my clothes with two bottles. Well, and I might be wrong on this. Sword might be a different one. On that might be the arrows from 9-5. The 2671 is arrows is from 9-5, I think. And the three arrows that Jonathan took with him, which I've been saying is the three consecutive draws that result from them adding a third Powerball draw to the mix on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday night on Satan's calendar. But three arrows, three much levity. Who's this with his clothes in verse 1, leavened. And if you look at your leavening, is leavening that your leavened bread of life that you live off of is because you're drunk off the wine of our fornication to our maker. You're drunk off the wine of fornication to him, playing the whore to him, loving and worshiping your make-believe images of him that tell you it's okay to live in rebellion to him. That's your leavening. You're drunk off the wine. But he says I'm gonna come from Basra that way. So it means I'm gonna have those clothes on. That's why I tried to keep them on until they were falling off me and I couldn't put them on anymore. But it turns out that he wanted me to do another little exhibit here today for you. Because because in Isaiah 63, it sounds like him. I alone have tread the winepress. But you read on in like verse 7, it's not referring to him. It's referring to his redeemed and such. But it's just what it is. Ishi. Hosea 2:16 for light. Hosea 2:16, you no longer call me Baali, but you'll call me man. So it's just reality that and I alone have treaded the winepress and my clothes, but I'm going to come from Edom, from the midst of Edom, from Basra, from the sheep gate, the sheep enclosure, with my clothes fermented. Three measures of leavening, because it's the word for leavening. I'm sorry, the word fermented means leavening. Leavened means leaven. I skipped that, but it's the word translates leavened. Is that with my clothes leavened? Three bottles. So there's another, it's going to be cold. Sun pops out every once in a while in the clouds, but at least I don't have the wind. He didn't send the wind that he sent the last couple of days because it was brutal, just brutal for the wind, but it's not been a burden. It's been a delight to fulfill his word and stuff. So I'm happy to do it. And now he's giving me the sun. I'm sure the sun will come out for good once I do this because I'm quite away from camp. But the reality is, who is this that comes from Basra? And it's interesting, too. There's more to it, and I'm going out of order because I don't have notes. But it's interesting because in the Song of His Beloved, in 2:17, the last verse of the 17th, the last verse of the second chapter, 2:17, paralleling Noah's birthday, the day he brought him in the world, and paralleling the day he sent the flood. But 2:17 of Song of His Beloved, which is His beloved to stand before your faces, the wife says that I would skip as a rose upon the mountains, of the mountains, 2022 for this year, of Bezer, 1336, that would be tomorrow. 1336 from the Elijah dream waypoint, Elijah vision waypoint. 1336, exact same as 1335, means to divide of that Genesis 15 prophecy for the Chiching prophecy for me, for him being my exceedingly abundant reward. And Abraham believed him because in Isaiah 59, before it goes into 53, Isaiah 51, he says that I'm his end time Abraham, and to consider that. And the wife that's fled in the wilderness is his end time Sarah. But, then he goes on six verses later in chapter 3, the first verse of what's called the third song. They cause him to number it that way, the third song. And he talks about me coming from the wilderness, coming out from the wilderness. But, from the wilderness or someplace else. But later on in it, maybe chapter 8, but somebody says, yes, I'm going to come out with like a pillar. Like, but in 3:6, just six verses later after the mountains of Bezer, which is the mountains, 2022 of Bezer, 1336, same as 1335, six verses later, he says that be as pillars of smoke, it says, but it's not, it's palm tree, mushroom cloud of smoke. It's only used one other place, it's in Joel, and it might even be Joel 2:17, but it's used in Joel where it talks about the mushroom cloud, the pillars of smoke. It talks about the sun and the moon, the signs that you can send in the dual heavens. Pillars of smoke, mushroom cloud. This morning he showed me a vision when I was meditating. I always a vision of a mushroom cloud. Wow, World War Z is at hand indeed. Indeed at hand. Complete with a little Zinfandel wine washing today to fulfill Isaiah chapter 63 and what comes from it. But he says that I'm going to be with, like as in frankincense, smelling of frankincense and myrrh in that verse in Song of His Beloved, chapter 3, 6, verse 6. And today's day number 36 of the year, our Maker's Restored calendar. But and with all pillars, with all powders, Strong's number 81, it's all powders of the merchant. Which Strong number 81 I talked about yesterday about being 321 with the prison mattress and everything of that Elijah dream and the steamboat mattress tying into it too. And the day that 81, day number 81 of the year, 321 of the year, is the day that he turned the waters of the Nile into blood. Yesterday's video, Strong's number 81. Only use that one place in the song of his beloved. So wow, that's amazing. Folks, his word is coming to pass, and I believe him. So with the believing him out here, and it's probably right at freezing or so, but in believing him, I'm going to take some of that good Mr. Z wine, that Zinfandel 14.8. I'm going to take a swig first, if you don't mind, and because you're getting ready to drink in a cup of the fierceness of his hot, hot indignation. Ah, good stuff indeed. Might take one more sip. Get ready to drink. I might as well just do a thorough job here. Last time it was actually washed, like I said, on 539. Work up a sweat here, taking a bath with this stuff. Drunk, utterly drunk off the wine of your fornication to our Maker. We have to talk about the title of this video, the seduced of Yehweh. In Jeremiah chapter 20, verse 7, parallel to Mars 207 waypoint for the 13th lap, the seven laps of the seventh day. But he says, you've deceived me, Yehweh. And really, the reality is, it means to be seduced or enticed. But it ties into the Genesis. It's a different word, but Genesis. It's what he said. I washed my clothes in wine, my persuasion in the blood of grapes. But he's persuaded me. He's seduced me with the testimony of his word. Testifies I'm his anointed. I got to believe him. Got to believe him to do what I'm doing today here. So wow. Wow, can't remember I saying I never had a drink of wine in the morning before. Maybe New Year's Day back when I was in the world or something. Not wine, maybe the mimosa or something. Wow, good stuff, like I said. Good to the last drop. Not quite. So the question is, almost the last drop. Am I drunk or are you drunk? The question is,